The 2014 season for the Suzuki MotoGP team kicked off at the Sepang circuit in Malaysia. And this is the man who is leading the team. Davide Brivio.
Let's say that in Sepang 1 we made a lot of experience. Basically we anticipated a little bit the new electronic introduction. So as I said, in 2014 we will have the new ECU, Magneti Marelli ECU, so we started to develop the software. The plan was to introduce this new electronic only on Sepang 2, so on Sepang test at the end of February. But we, because the engineer, they made, let's say, a good job, they worked very hard, so we decided to introduce this new electronic at the beginning of February during Sepang 1 testing. So, Sepang 1 was a little bit difficult because we had to fix many problems due to the new system, but we made a good experience and we collected many information. So we come here in Sepang 2 with some updating based on that information and that problem, and we are keen to continue this job. And as you know, we have 1 year time to develop this new system. So basically, the work, the development work, has started earlier than expected.
The team of development riders consists of the same three riders from the 2013 season. Randy Depunier. Nobuatsu Aoki. Taki Yatsuda. Conditions on the circuit are not good on this occasion, and the riders struggle to get a grip on the track surface. But new software has been developed, and many new specs have been introduced into the hardware, including the inline 4 engine, allowing the team to go through the test items steadily.
Of course, in terms of, I think, chassis and engine side, as I said, Suzuki has a lot of experience, has clever engineers, so I'm not too worried about this. I think we've of course, hard job, but we can achieve this, we can get this. This new MotoGP machine has a 4-cylinder inline, and this is something new for Suzuki in a racing, four-stroke racing activity. But of course, Suzuki has a long experience and a long history with the 4-cylinder inline, which is used in a mass production, especially the GX-XR. And I have to say that the MotoGP engine was very good. Was always very reliable. We never had any problem. And we are working on the development, so I have to say that very good start with a new, let's say, racing technology.